Hey guys.
Hey Bo.
Hi Bo.
Flippin' physics.
Ladies and gentle people, the bell has rung, therefore class has begun, therefore you should be seated in your seat, ready and excited to walk some graphs of position as a function of time.
Yep.
Yes.
Okay.
One of the things that you're going to be responsible to do in this class is to be able to understand, interpret, and draw position as a function of time, velocity as a function of time, and acceleration as a function of time graphs. Today we're going to work on position as a function of time. We'll get to velocity and acceleration as a function of time in a later lesson. So let's start. We're going to draw position as a function of time. We're going to deal with several graphs today that have to do with position as a function of time. We'll have position on what we would normally call the y-axis and time on what we would normally call the x-axis. So again, position in meters on the y-axis and time in seconds on the x-axis. Let's just start with a single line on our position as a function of time graph, which I've drawn here. And we're going to talk about the slope. Bo, what's the symbol for slope?
The symbol for slope, I don't think I remember.
It's a lowercase m.
Oh, that's right, thanks. A lowercase m.
Great, the symbol for slope is a lowercase m. Billy, what is the slope of a line?
The slope of the line is the rise of the line over the run of the line.
Very good, the definition of slope is that it is the rise over run of a line. In other words, if you take a certain time period, you will see that we have a certain run during that time period and we go through a certain amount of rise during that time period. So the slope of the line is if you take the rise during a certain time period and divide it by the run during that same time period. Bobby, what's the equation for the slope of a line?
Y equals mx plus b.
Actually, that's the slope-intercept form of a straight line equation. Nah, not the equation for slope.
That's right. The equation for slope, it's change in y over change in x.
Very good. Slope is equal to rise over run. It's also equal to the change in y over change in x. But we don't have a y-axis and we don't have an x-axis. We have, instead of a y-axis, a position axis. Instead of an x-axis, we have a time axis. So instead of slope equals change in y over change in x, it's going to be the change in position over the change in time. In other words, the slope of a position versus time graph is equal to the change in position over change in time. Change in position over change in time. That sounds really familiar. Anybody have any idea what that is? Oh, come on. We just defined this. Class, what is change in position over change in time?
Velocity.
Velocity. That's right. Displacement over change in time is equal to velocity.
One thing that you absolutely have to know is that the slope of a position versus time graph is velocity. Again, the slope of a position versus time graph is velocity. What we're going to do now is I'm going to draw a graph of position as a function of time. I'm going to put a line on that graph and I'm going to ask a student to come forward and to be the object for that graph, to walk that graph, to walk the position as a function of time graph. Let's actually start out by getting our bearings, understanding where things are on the graph. Here we go. All right, every graph we're going to walk in this class is going to be done on the sidewalk right out in front of my house. So we have to get our bearings. If you are on the time axis, you'll be standing on the sidewalk right in front of the front door. If instead you are below the time axis, you will be to the left of the front door, still on the sidewalk. If you are above the time axis, you will be to the right of the front door, again, still on the sidewalk. One more time. If you are on the time axis, you will be right in front of the front door. If you are below the time axis, you will be to the left of the front door. And if you are above the time axis, you will be to the right of the front door. Let's draw our first line. All right, this is our first graph. One thing to make sure that we understand when you start and stop, please say start right when you start walking and stop when you are done walking the graph. Billy, could you please give it a try. Could you please start walking this graph?
Wait, you want me to go outside?
Yes, please go outside and give it a try.
Okay. Start!
No, stop! Please! Please don't walk across the street.
Dude, weren't you paying attention when we learned about displacement? Look both ways before you cross the street.
And always cross corner to corner. Okay, one common misconception with this graph is because the line is diagonal that you must walk in a diagonal direction. It's not true. There is only one spatial dimension on this graph. There is a time dimension, but only one spatial dimension, which means you should always be on the sidewalk. It's just one linear dimension along the sidewalk. So please give it a try again, but this time stay completely on the sidewalk. One linear dimension.
Oh, okay. Start. Stop!
That's exactly it. Notice he started to the left of the front door, and as time went by, he slowly went toward the front door and then ended up to the right of the front door, just like it says on the graph. Very nice. Billy, why don't you come back inside? Let's do the next graph. Bo, could you please give this one a try?
Okay.
Start. Stop.
All right. Let's talk about this one. Billy, what do you think? Did he walk the graph correctly?
Well, there is a line, so he should be moving. Actually, if you look at the line, as time goes by, he's always in that same spot, just to the right of the front door. So he actually shouldn't move at all. I think he did an excellent job.
Well, yeah. And the slope of the line is zero, and the slope of a position versus time graph is velocity. Therefore, his velocity should be zero. Therefore, he shouldn't move at all. That makes sense.
Very nice, guys. Bo, why don't you please come back in? Let's do the next example. Bobby, could you please give this one a try?
Start. Stop.
Well, class, how do you think you did?
I ain't got no beef with that.
Looks good to me.
All right. Well, then I have a question. Was he facing the correct direction? He was facing forward as he walked, but should he have actually been facing the other direction and walked backward?
It doesn't matter.
The direction he should be facing isn't indicated on the graph.
That is correct. There is nothing on the graph that tells us the direction that he should be facing, only the way he should be moving, the direction that he's going to go. I have another question. Other than the fact we can tell he started to the right of the front door and he ended to the left of the front door, what's another way we can tell from the line that he should be moving to the left?
Oh. Again, it's that the slope is velocity. The slope of that line is negative, and therefore his velocity is negative, and to the left is negative.
Absolutely. Remember, the slope of a position versus time graph is velocity. We went through and showed that before. The slope of a position versus time graph is velocity. And this slope of this line, because the rise is actually negative as time goes by, that means this slope is negative. Therefore, he should have a negative velocity, negative slope, negative velocity, and a negative velocity is to the left. Therefore, Bobby was absolutely right to be walking to the left or having a negative velocity. Great. Bobby, can you come back in? Let's do one more graph. Ryan, how about you give this one a try? Please.
I always love it when his kids help.
Yeah, they sure know their physics too.
Glad I don't have to give it a try.
Start. Stop.
Excellent. Great job, Ryan.
Winnie. But the problem is that she actually did do something wrong, and we need to talk about it. You can see in part one. So again, in part one, she started at the front door, she walked to the right of the front door, and then for part two, she paused for quite a while. And then for part three, she moved from to the right of the front door to the left of the front door. But she did do something incorrectly. What was it?
I don't think your kids can do anything wrong.
I agree with Billy.
Me too, nothing wrong.
Please, we all make mistakes, even me. Come on.
Velocity, it's the slope again. Notice that the slope in part three is actually greater than the slope in part one. Therefore, she needs to be moving faster in part three. Actually, because the slope in part one is positive and the slope in part three is negative, technically the slope in part one is greater than the slope in part three.
That is true, Billy. However, I usually do it in terms of the magnitude because it's easier to see there. You can see the magnitude of the slope or the magnitude of the velocity in part one is less than the magnitude of the slope or the magnitude of the velocity in part three. In other words, the magnitude of the velocity in part three is greater than the magnitude of the velocity in part one. In other words, she should be moving faster in part three than in part one. Great. Ryan, could you do it one more time, but this time do it correctly, please.
Start.
Another way to look at this is that in part one, she had a large amount of time to go through a short distance, whereas in part three, she had a short amount of time to go a large distance. In other words, she needs to move faster in part three than she does in part one. You could clearly see from the example problems that I've done that it's very important to remember that the slope of a position as a function of time graph is velocity. Please remember that. Ladies and gentlemen, people, I enjoyed learning with you today. I hope that you enjoyed learning with me.
Lecture notes are available at flippingphysics.com. Please enjoy lecture notes responsibly.